and I can go out and get those and put it together. And then we know, okay, here's what our cost, true cost is per unit. And then we get out there and we start doing the hustle. So one of the differences, huge differences in the markets today, where in the old days, you know, you were a loser if you didn't get with New York, that the savvy author is really weighing out the options. Okay, so if I've got a marketing plan, if I'm working on a marketing plan, it's like I have a client I'm working with right now who's down in Texas who owns an extraordinarily successful restaurant. His marketing starts there. The buzz starts there on his memoirs and life. And I'm pretty comfortable that he will move at least 1,000 copies of his book within 2 months. That tells me all of his costs for production, my consulting, the work he's had to do, will be repaid within 1 month, and then he's on a cash cow from moving on. So, you know, that's part of the strategies that you have to look at. So how am I going to get it out there? What do I do to create that buzz so I can bring in 1,000 sales in 21 days or a week? Or I did it with a phone call. So how can you do that kind of thing? And it's really, you know, getting one of the biggest mistakes authors, I ask them all the time, Ryan, who is your audience? Who is your book? I want you to put it on your laptop. Put down your laptop right now. Okay, who is on the other side? Who do you see? Is it a him or her? How old are they? What do they love? What do they hate? What are their hopes? What are their fears? What do they play with? What do they do? Who are you writing for? Most can't answer that question. And you're not going to succeed in selling books unless you can. Critical. Cool.